Ely is one of the smallest cities in England. Its ancient name commemorates the importance of eel catching to the city and the surrounding fens. Mark's meeting cathedral guide, Michael.
Hello, Michael.
Yes, hello, Mark.
How are you?
Very well, thank you. And you're very welcome to Ely Cathedral.
I'm delighted to be here. It's pretty spectacular, isn't it?
Amazing, amazing.
I bet the inside is much more interesting than the outside in some
ways. Yes, let me show you.
Ely Cathedral is dedicated to St. Etheldreda, the Saxon princess who founded the abbey here in the year 673. Work began on the present cathedral in the 11th century. The glorious Norman building survives, but there have been some modifications over the years.
We're now coming in to our octagon tower.
All right, okay.
Which replaces the Norman tower, which stood on this spot for something like 200 years, but fell in February 1322.
Good Lord.
And created a great hole in the centre of the cross of the building. But with great enterprise, Alan of Walsingham, our sacrist at the time, rebuilt the tower much wider than before for extra security. But the really impressive bit is the way the wooden roof has been created. It's an entirely new style for the 1300s.
Really?
Yes. The lantern in the middle is made of 8 enormous oak trees standing on end, 63 feet long.
Well, it looks pretty spectacular up there, doesn't it?
For a better look at the cathedral's stunning octagon tower, they're climbing up to the heavens.
How many steps?
About 165.
Oh, right, OK. I'm looking forward to this.
Yeah.
Are you sure, Mark?
Perhaps your knees won't.
No. Wow.
And now we're in the roof space.
And then you can walk right round.
You can walk right round, and more spectacularly, you can open these doors.
Wow.
And you can get to look down into the church.
Oh, good Lord. Gosh. It really is quite spectacular, isn't it? They are beautiful when you get up here, aren't they?
These paintings were added during a 19th century restoration of the cathedral. The work was completed in 1864. But there's yet another part of the magnificent cathedral to explore.
I'd like to take you into Our Lady Chapel, the largest in Britain, the widest vaulted ceiling then attempted. That was in the early 1400s.
Gosh. I mean, looking around, all this wonderful carving.
It's carved in a very soft white stone. It's a hard form of chalk called clunch.
Right.
You'll notice that it's very seriously damaged.
It is, you can see that. All the heads are missing by the looks of it.
We think that at the time of the Reformation, under the orders of the bishop here, Bishop Goodrich, somebody went round possibly on horseback and simply knocked all the heads off the saints.
During the Reformation of the 1500s, many of Britain's religious icons were destroyed in the belief that they were ungodly. The chapel has one last unique property that Michael's keen to share.
The acoustics here are really rather special. It's such a big enclosed space that it produces a 7-second echo.
Really?
If I clap my hands, you can get some impression.
Gosh, that's quite spectacular, isn't it? Michael, thank you so much. I've had a wonderful afternoon, you know. I've learned so much. I will need to rest well tonight after those stairs, but I wouldn't have missed it for the world. Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you, Mark.
Goodbye.